There were a lot of times in my career where I needed to learn a programming language within days. And I felt that no matter what I tried, I just couldn't get it right. But then I developed this framework. And with it, I was able to go from zero understanding to solid foundation very quickly, no matter the programming language. So here is how I learn a programming language within days. So it's day zero and I want to learn a programming language. What do I do first? I tell you what I don't do. I don't go to Google and search Python for beginners or JavaScript for beginners. I stopped thinking about programming languages as lines of code a long time ago. When I think about learning a programming language, I think about project. What project can I do once I learn this language? That is all that matters to me. So day zero is where I research popular projects that are built with a language that I want to learn. It can be anything like a weather app on JavaScript or a dashboard on Python. But either way, I will find two projects and make sure that they are beginner friendly because I don't want to stress myself out learning any advanced concepts too soon. So now that I have my two projects, the rest of my day consists of overview of the language and history. It's always nice to know why people like the language and how it started. And then I'm ready for my coding environment to be set up. This is where I figure out how to install the language interpreter or compiler, as well as a code editor. I then work out how to run my first program, which is Hello World. And once I'm happy with that, that's when I start learning the basic language syntax and structures. Now, this is the bread and butter of your coding language. I learn about variables, operators, and data types, as well as control structures like for loops, conditionals, and maybe I cover some functions as well. I spend about 2 days gathering knowledge about the fundamentals of the programming language. It can be things like watching YouTube videos or doing a short online course. And what I learn here is quite important because the projects that I want to complete will depend on basic foundational knowledge. But then it's time to move on. Once I know my foundation, the next thing I do is separate my project into two parts: front-end development and back-end development. Front-end development is where you imagine that you're a painter and your project or application is the canvas. Your goal is to make the canvas beautiful and inviting for its users. To kickstart my front-end journey, I research what my project needs. Maybe my project is a weather app. Then I will want to research some popular front-end libraries, such as React, Angular, or Vue.js for JavaScript. And just a note, with Python, it doesn't really do front-end, but you can make this about data analytics, charts, or dashboards. Now, back-end development is where you create and maintain the infrastructure that powers the application, such as databases, servers, and APIs. To drive the back-end development, I again see what my project needs and then explore the popular back-end development libraries. So for Python, I might check out Flask or Django, and for JavaScript, I might check out Node.js or even Express. Then I start designing my user interface and user experience, which is front-end, and then I build the server-side logic and data management for my backend, and this powers my project. I don't worry about becoming an expert in these libraries. I'm not here to become an expert in a matter of days. I'm just here to pick the specific frameworks, libraries, and tools to get my project done. And I spend about 3 days learning this. So now I know the basics and I've learned the concepts of front-end and back-end development. And by now I would have definitely come across errors in my code. 100% there will be errors and bugs. And it's really important to know how to handle and squash these errors in code because this will always happen. So I need to make sure I'm writing clean, readable code because nobody wants to read messy code. I have a look at style guides and even linters. And sometimes, despite my best efforts, errors will still pop up in my code. And that's where exception handling comes in. Think of it like a safety net that catches any errors before it causes chaos in your project or application. So here I take a day or two editing my code and figuring out how to anticipate potential issues. For instance, on Python, I can use try and accept statements. But the goal here is to make sure that your code runs fine. And if there are any errors, how would you deal with it? At this stage, I should now have good foundational knowledge of my programming language. My project should now be close to completion, but now I take the time to fully understand the process and see if there are any similar projects I can start with or build up on my current project. Because as I progress, I would encounter new challenges and new errors, and learning to solve this would help me become a good developer. Now, during this stage, you may also notice that coding can be very lonely, and it definitely doesn't have to be. So around this stage, I always make an effort to join a developer community, ask questions, network a bit. And the developer community for newcomers is always very welcoming. Reddit, Twitter, YouTube, even Slack has some great communities for newcomers in programming languages. Now, as I continuously work on my projects, I keep trying to refine and optimize my code and streamline the processes. And those four pillars will give you a solid foundation. The fifth pillar is what happens next. How do you continuously grow? The fifth pillar is where I try and start tackling some advanced concepts that I just found interesting. So using the same process, I will research what advanced concepts I can add to my project. This can be topics like design patterns, algorithms, data structures, whatever. I then research popular processes, tools, and frameworks, and try and link it back to my project. Now, I must note that the world of programming is ever changing, and it's really important for you to keep up with the trends, try out new processes, practices, frameworks, etc. that come up. And that's it. That's five pillars to learn one language. This is the exact framework that I have used when I needed to learn a programming language very fast, and it hasn't let me down yet.